Right, back on site. Customers literally, as I pulled up, door open. Can you smell the kettle or something? Or hear it? It was like I have 6 cents for tea. So, a nice cup of tea already. And as you can see, it rained last night. Hoping it's not too wet and sticky in this hole. It's a bit sheltered around here, but I am in there probably most of the day. I've got a tunnel under 600 mil that way from the face of this wall. I've got to make sure when I'm underneath, I scrape all the mud off the underside of this footing to make sure it's clean. So when the concrete floods up, there's no material that can compact underneath between the old footing and the new concrete. So you've got to really get the underside of that footing clean. That's my next job. Not really looking forward to it, but once this is done, all I've got to do then is a little bit more cleaning up over there. Clean that up. Clean all this. Look, my beautiful clean trench has been battered by the weather and there's all crap everywhere, so that needs cleaning up. Scrape that back. Toe under there and put rebar into there. So that's today's jobs. So I'm in said hole. I've got my trusty new SDS spade ready and the all important My Fair shovel from Fisher Price. This has dug a lot of these stupid holes, but I've never combined it with that, so I'm hoping to speed up the process considerably. I'll set you up and let's get on with it. Oh, well, as you can see, as expected, I've nearly ruined my only vest today. So if I end up stripping off, it's not because I'm trying to show off, because I really haven't got much to show off. It's just I cannot stand being enclosed that are wringing wet. So apologies for that. Avert your eyes if it offends you. I'm going to have to start sitting on my ass now. So I'm going to try and find myself a nice comfy seat, because otherwise I'm going to have a wet backside as well. And that's just a double whammy of shiitake mushrooms there. So yeah. I'm about a third of the way through and lost about a third of body weight in moisture. So, yeah, back to it. Well, luck has it, I still had these bad boys on the van. I think they were a freebie, actually. To be honest, I always leave them in the van. All the old boys go, ooh, where's your protection for your knees? When you get to my age, you're going to have knackered knees. Well, you're probably right, mate, but when you're in the thick of it, you just want to kneel down quickly, don't you, and get back up again rather than going, oh, I'll know. I'll go to the van and pick up my kneely pad because I... Oh, poltergeist. Yeah, those knee pad things that, well, I don't wear trousers ever. You'll still see me in these shorts in the midst of winter. Oh, I've got a cut on my leg there. Because they're terrible. They just slide down to your shins. They end up, when your trousers stretch, they end up being shin rests. And who rests on their shins? Exactly. Don't know whether to double them up as a cushion or spread them next to each other so I got more of a, you know, protection from the wet bottom. But we'll see. I've decided to go for the old double up for comfort. I think comfort's, you know, most of my little tiny butts will fit on there. My own missus is always taking a mick out of my butt. I haven't got one, literally. I've not got a bum. You know, but is that good or bad? I don't know. Anyway, comments. Having a quick break. Rose has just kindly bought me a pint of squash. I've reached the depth under the house that way. I need to be in the middle. All I gotta do now is clean it up square and flat. So yeah, I'm just having a fire, actually. Whoa! I bet there's people going, ooh, you can't do that. Well, what can you do these days? Do you know what I mean? a man can't make a fire on his own building site when the customer's requested it. So that's what I'm doing. And, do you know what I mean? It's like, when I was a kid growing up, with people our age, I'm not going to tell you my age, but like Forward probably says it all, we used to bomb around doing all sorts. We used to ride our bikes through the corridors in the hospital. We used to, you know, break into garages and steal their naughty mags. We used to do all sorts. Hangers, like army hangers, we used to try and break into them. It was just what kids did back then. You did stuff until someone went, "Oi, you're not allowed to do that." And then you went, "Oh, sorry," pretending like you were innocent and said we didn't realise. And then that was it, end of story. You didn't get arrested, you didn't get anything. You just got like told off by some grown-up. That was all they were, grown-ups. These days, oh my God. It's like, it used to be, just do something until someone tells you you can't. Now, it's don't do anything until someone tells you you can. Correct me if I'm the only person who feels like that, but Jesus, we are so under the thumb of authority, it is unbelievable. Anyway, this is a different topic. But yeah, I'm on the bloody fire with a pint of squash and a fag. Anyway, I reckon the structural engineer is dodging Andrew's number for some reason. Don't know why. He said he's nothing, no bad blood, nothing went wrong, he paid him, everything's sorted. So I'm going to ring him now and do the old test to see if he's just got Andrew's number on don't answer. So yeah, here goes nothing. Well, I just rang him and it rang off the first time. Tried a second time and did the same thing. So I've left a very polite message and I'm hoping he'll get back to me because concrete's coming Thursday and then it's literally my next job, and if I don't know what I'm doing, then I can't do it. I can preempt, because I know what needs to be done, I think, and it's definitely not what's on that drawing. So I could preempt and just crack on, but you know what happens then, don't you? Assumption is the mother of all. What film is that from? I don't know. Very true though. This there, that's our existing footing. I don't know if you can see under here. So this is the underside of our footing. As is, it goes, this is all the way back, because that there is the footing for the internal wall going that way through the house. And then what you've got to make sure, I've made sure, so this is the edge of the external footing here. It's really hard to see, but I've made sure I've gone up further, so when the concrete floods in, it's definitely fully supported. So I've done that there, and I've also gone up a bit in the corner there. I don't know if you can see it. Those stones are actually stones bedded in the concrete. That's why they won't come out, so that's fine. Yeah, so I've squared it up as best I can. So yeah, it's just a hole really, not really interesting, but if you're thinking of having a go yourself, I mean, it's not rocket science, just make sure you've had drawings done by a structural engineer and just follow them basically. It's just digging a hole really. I think we've got to put some reinforcing mesh in. Well, as you can probably tell from the time lapse, I was a little bit awkward trying to get underneath there, but I don't know if you can see. We've now got suspended now our mesh at the bottom, at least 50mm above there, and mesh at the top, at least 50mm below the top. So that's that little job done, thank God.